broke box office records on Broadway, and now it's here in Hawaii, but only for a limited time. It's Only a Play at Hawaii Theater stars Linda Purl, Cathy Foy, Paul Mitri, and our very own Joe Moore. Joe and Cathy are here this morning. Thank you both for being with us.
He's having fun.
I don't normally see you before
2 p.m. I didn't get dressed up. Oh, but I did wear a shirt. I thought you might,
It's only a play.
I'm not plugging anything, you understand?
Of course not. In fact, Taizo and I did have a chance to see opening night. I have to say, you both were fantastic.
Thank you.
We really, really enjoyed it.
Thanks.
And I love live theater. I mean, we do live television every day.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But you walk away from live theater and you have such admiration for the people on stage. It's hard work. I can't imagine doing what you guys do.
It's hard, but it's fun.
Yes, it's lots and lots of fun. You never know what's going to happen. You never, ever know what's going to happen because that is, you know, you're doing everything in the moment. And I'm just so honored and so humbled to be a part of this incredibly talented cast. Thank you, Joe. Thank you.
Well, I knew, you know, I have little conversations in my head when I'm going to cast something like this.
Yes.
And I said, you know, if I could get Cathy Foy to play this role that she plays in the play, she will bring the house down. And we've done five performances so far. Every time the house is just in stitches. So
well, I have to say, I love Joe, but your character.
And Trini, this character is really outside the box for me. Very outside the box because I'm doing and saying things that I normally don't do.
Oh, sure.
She plays a diva actress who, shall we say, knows her way around pharmaceuticals.
Yes. Yeah. No, it's my favorite character of the show.
Thank you.
And you do a fantastic job.
Thank you.
I was going to ask you, I mean, how do you prepare for a role like that?
I sort of try to observe different people, you know, characters. And there was a show called Absolutely Fabulous.
Here's some shots from the play.
But you try to make the, you know, character your own. But Stockard Channing, you know, who is such an incredible actress, our director, Logan Reed, was so kind. He brought the props from the Broadway show, and I'm actually carrying Stockard Channing's purse and her compact, and her lip gloss is still in there, and I'm just...
That stuff arrived at Hawaii, you should have seen her. She was like acting like a six-year-old.
Oh my God, this was
Stockard Channing's purse on Broadway.
So you also still feel excited when
it is a thrill. It's an absolute thrill to be, you know, a part of such an incredible cast. And everything, you know, it is outrageously funny,
funny,
but they're very poignant, emotional moments. And for me, if I might be so perfectly honest, you know, one moment where it's extremely emotional and touching is that moment when you, Joe, look to Peter and you're talking about your father.
Yes.
And there isn't a dry eye in the audience, you know, when the emotion and the feelings that come out, you know, and Joe is talking about his dad.
So the play,
let's back up a little bit. I saw it, but for people who didn't see the play, tell us what it's about.
The play is set at an opening night party on Broadway. A play's just open, and the cast, some of the cast members, the director and the author are there. I'm the playwright's best friend who turned down a role in the play because I didn't think the play was very good and went to do a TV series in Hollywood. Now, I've come back on opening night to support my friend, but I have mixed emotions. I want the play to succeed for him, but I want it to fail so to validate my decision not to do this play. Mm-hmm. There's all kind of interesting dynamics. Desmond Gila seen here plays a just off the plane coat check boy from Hawaii, a wannabe actor. Ryan Wusterwald is this off the wall British director, very hot talent, but has some quirks that people will find interesting, I think.
How do you bring a show like that to Hawaii? How do we get it?
I wrote a letter, snail mail, to Terrence McNally, the four-time Tony-winning playwright, and said, I love your work. I'd love to do this play in Hawaii. We'll get a professional cast and crew. You will not be embarrassed by this. So it turns out we've got four actors in the cast who either are New York actors, been on Broadway, or have been, or presently still are. Anyway, and I said, it's going to be a benefit for Hawaii Theater. We'd like to do 11 performances. And he's had his assistant, Logan Reed, who is a director in his own right, has directed successful plays on Broadway. He sent a letter back, or an email back, saying, it's very unusual for Mr. McNally to do this. In fact, he's never done it before. While one of his plays is running on Broadway, he is granting you the rights for Hawaii.
Wow.
So we're the first place in the country. Like a week and a half after it closes on Broadway, boom, it's at Hawaii Theater.
I have chicken skin listening to that script. Just the fact that he responded.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's like my wife can tell you, I've always worked under the philosophy, you know, if you don't ask, the answer is going to be no.
Yes.
So, and what's the worst? What was the worst that could happen? He either emails or snail mails back, no, you can't have the rights.
And then.
Yeah, and then so it's not like he's going to shoot you for asking.
Now, you obviously have a passion for theater. Tell us real quick, where did that passion come from?
I think it really came from my mother's side of the family, the, you know, the flair for the dramatic and liking theater and participating in these kind of things. And so just over the years, it's. Some people golf, others fish. I do plays.
Mm-hmm. And this is a benefit for Hawaii Theater.
Six more performances starting tomorrow night, Wednesday night. So Wednesday night, Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday afternoon, night, and then Sunday afternoon, and pow.
Okay, we highly encourage you to check it out, and I'm not saying that because you guys are sitting next to me. Both Taizo and I really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
So thank you. You guys did a great job.
It will be open soon, and call this number, 528-0506. And Linda Purl, who has Hawaii ties, is incredible.
Yes.
And she's
She plays the novice producer. Yes.
It's
very
exciting to see her on stage because you're like, oh my God, I remember all the movies that she's been in.
Yes. And TV. Yeah.
Okay, now you heard Joe say, if you don't ask, you never know, right?
That's right.
Well, I can't let you leave, Joe, without saying what's under your hat.
Well, I have the distinction of probably having the worst hair of any television anchorman in the country. So
I don't know about that.
I didn't do a thing. This is what my wife wakes up to every morning, okay?
It's like... Okay, that's not too bad.
But
that's
don't you love the cap? I mean,
I think that's her way of saying put the cap back on.
You're like a young kid. And he's so excited. I don't know where he gets the energy. When we were rehearsing, you know, he'd do the 6 o'clock news, come in, rehearse, go back and do the 10 o'clock. I don't know where you get that energy.
It's because he's passionate about
it.
Yeah. Well, I'm a very young man.
Yes, he is young at heart, and doesn't he look fabulous?
Speaking of rehearsals, when did you guys start rehearsing?
What do we have, about 11 days of rehearsal, rehearsing 2 times a day, 2 big sessions a day, and then finally moved into the theater, and sometimes we're rehearsing even before we do a performance, like we're going to do a run-through tomorrow afternoon just to make sure all the lines are still there since we've been off for 2 days.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, thank you both for being with us.
Thank you, Trini.
Again, it's only a play. It plays at Hawaii Theater Wednesday through Sunday, and that's it, so you've got to get your tickets now.
You'll love it.
Coming up after the break, we are going to wrap things up. We'll tell you what we have coming up tomorrow when Living 808 returns.